they couldn't deliver me from the drugs. I'm talking about I was a hardcore addict too. Some of these folks here playing with me, they knew me before, and they know me now. I believe that they can tell the difference. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Only God can make the change. Sometimes we want to help other people try to change. We think that if we stay in a relationship that we might help make a difference in that person's life. But we couldn't change ourselves. It took Jesus Christ coming and dying on the cross and shed his blood for us to be able to change. So only he can do the change. So this Keith Gregg over here, been a friend of our families for years. I don't remember him because I know he used to go to my great aunt and great uncles in Habersham County, and I didn't really know him until later on in life. And this is his brother-in-law, Billy Eads. Billy's done a little bit of everything. He's drummed for, I think, Porter Wagner, Little Jimmy Dickens. And Keith is, and his wife, she's around here somewhere. They had a group, and I used to drive their bus for them. So, anyway, I'll shut up.
Now we're about to be driving his bus.
That's it.
So anyway, yes, Donna was my cousin. And it's sad because of the drug addiction. After I got older, I wasn't around her very much. I was out west when she passed away. But her dad was an excellent musician. He built fiddles and played the banjo and the guitar. He wrote a book on playing the banjo. He played with Carl Story, a lot of different people. And
thank you.
So Donna, she's the oldest. I remember going to see her when I was a kid. I think about a little story here. It's really not to do with Donna, but my Uncle Don, he smoked cigarettes. And one day, I was probably 8 years old. And we went to see him in Highlands, and he took me outside, and he handed me a cigarette. And he thought he was going to make me sick. Where I wouldn't want them anymore, you know, they used to do that. But I kept on smoking it, and it didn't make me sick. He had to take it back away from me. My mom and dad was not happy.
You ready?
I'll pay you. We have to remember that we're dynamically and individually unique. There'll never be another like us in the history of mankind or like you. Never has been, nor will ever be. You're so special that God made you different than everybody else. You don't need anybody's approval, and you don't need to perform a certain way to be accepted or approved of by God. And that's all that matters.
Sprinkle it?
Yeah, a little baptism right there.
Christ are here today and gone tomorrow.
Country music,
she
married a face like this.
I'm telling you.
Joey's
going
to have to grow him some facial hair.
Yeah. See, I ended up getting me some of these Doc Martin boots. And I got white ones, and they make fun of me because I got the white ones. But now everybody wants white Doc Martin boots and a poodle like I have. States and with the federal government. So we won't go into all that, but I tell you what, I'm thankful for where God has brought me from, where I'm at today, and where He's taken me to. I like to do this song because it talks about it is a Merle Haggard song, one called Fugitive, and it talks about Mama prayed those crops. I raised a lot of cane in my younger days. But Mama prayed that those crops would always fail. Boy, I tell you, every one of them did. I didn't reap nothing out of that but jail time. So, you asked that. I'm from Brayden County, and I have become friends with a lot of the investigator and the sheriff deputies. They knew me because they chased after me for a long time. And then I get to I was sitting with some the other day eating. I said, boy, it's sure nice to be able to sit down and eat next to you guys instead of having to run away from it. But the investigator, he's been hollering, want me to come by and bring several of the deputies and be singing along the track. So,
Let's do,
I've been in Florida this past week and that nice warm weather. And I got back, I'm sorry. I can only afford you at certain times. But I got back up here and it's cool weather. It's working on my throat a little bit. So let's do that.
Please don't.
This is the amen corner right down here, I can tell you.
Before you get finished here, Joey, I got to tell you, Donna was always proud of where you're at.
Right.
You know, and I was too. I didn't know you back in the old days, but, you know, because I used to be where you used to be in the old days.
Right.
You know, there wasn't a drug house I didn't know about, wasn't a bootlegger where I could haul 60 gallons from, anything and everything to illegally make money and stay high. So, you know, brother, I'm glad to see where you at today.
I didn't really know him until even after, for a while. He'd been married to Donna for a while. And I just happened to run into him in another store and got to talking, and that's when I found out he was married to my cousin. Like I said, I was in addiction. It was so bad that I'd actually disappeared. I didn't tell anybody where I was at. And I left home, and I ended up in Cates Cove in Tennessee. One reason I went to Tennessee is they don't extradite to Georgia. So that was my kind of hideout. But I ended up in Cates Cove. I was still using drugs, but I started going to those old churches to sing. I called Salvation in Cates Cove. A few months in there, I'd go in and sit down. I was still high, using drugs. People say, you was high singing in church. Well, yes, I was. But I was to the point that God had to show me that he could still use me, that I wasn't damaged goods. And during that time that I was singing, I was singing all three churches several hours a day, almost every day. And I seen people come to know the Lord through that. And I thought, here I am in this shape, and God, you're using me to touch these people. And that just blew my mind. So I had one man come up to me. I was in the last church, and I sang, and he came up to me, and he said, you said your name was Joey. And again, let me say this. It's not about me. It's all about him. Until we get ourselves out of the way, our will out of the way to do his will, things don't change. But when you give up all of your will to do his will, things really start to change. And but this gentleman came up to me and he said, you said your name was Joey? I said, yes, sir. He said, my name's Carl. He said, I'm from New York. There are now those churches in Gates Cove all day long, every few minutes from all over the world. He said, I'm from New York. He said, Joey, let me tell you something. I've been the meanest man all my life. He said, nobody likes me. He said, everybody hates me. And he said, you could call any number in my phone, they will not answer. He said, the only communication I have with anybody is through text, and it has to be to do with work. He said, Joey, I've been mean. He said, as a child, I went to church with my friends, or I went to church with my family. He said, but when I got to be a teenager, I started riding around with my friends. And he said, I didn't go back to church. He said, I'm 57 years old and hadn't been in church since I was a teenager up until today. He said, normally I'd ride through here. I wouldn't go into these churches. But he says, now I know why I did today. He said, as of today, God working through you has changed my life. He said, when I get back to New York, they're not going to know who I am. So it's a God thing. It's all about that. He can change every situation that we deal with. It may not be the way that we want it, but we have to be content with the way he has. His way is not our way. Our way is not his way. And we have to be content with whatever way his way is. And at times, we have to learn the hard way. I don't like learning the hard way, but so I just choose to be okay with where everything's at in my life now. I've experienced the most, 99% of my life is filled with joy and peace. And I just depend on him no matter what. I don't care how bad things look. I know he's still in control and he's still going to take care of me. And he says he'll never leave us or forsake us. That's one verse there that we should be focused on when we get into a problem. God's good in the good times. We say God is good all the time. All the time God is good. He's good in the good times, and he's good in the bad times. So we have to remind ourselves that. Let me give you a little drink of this water. We'll do one more song. And being all my times of standing before a judge in my life, actually, I've been blessed. I told you I was a fugitive with the United States government. I ended up going to court, federal court. The prosecution was asking for several years of drug programs and all kinds of stuff. But in the end, they played a gospel song off of my CD in the federal courthouse. Played the whole song. I thought it was just going to play a little bit of a song. Really didn't know what song. But they played that, and when it was all over, said, done with, the judge looked to both sides, the rest of the case, yes. And he said, I'm giving you 3 months probation, $300 restitution. And he said, he looked at prosecution and said, it has nothing to do with this, but I'd like for you to come back and sing in the federal courthouse for a naturalization ceremony. So I went back and sung in the federal courthouse while they added 63 new citizens to the United States. So God can take the mess and make a message out of it. So we'll do this mercy walk to you. And thank you for listening, and thank you for allowing me to be a part of this. We have to remember that it is all about the Lord, and I promise you He will take care of you no matter what's going on. If you've been carrying something in your that's going on in your life, I don't care what it is, an argument with a family member, whatever, today is the day of salvation, the Bible says, and I don't believe it's just salvation. I believe it is the day that we can be saved from our worries or our being mad at somebody, whatever it might be. So anyway, I finally made it to court in South Carolina. I was facing 30 years on one charge, and I had about 12 charges, but one carried a 30-year sentence max, and ended up going in there, been living for the Lord, and traveling, singing, and remember, it's all about Him. But I walked in there, and the judge got to me, and he said, Joey Dean Green. I said, there's something about that name. And so when it was over and done with, I got one misdemeanor charge, and then it was removed from my record. So I walked out there a free man. Again, God took something that I made a mess of and made a message out of it. So anyway, I found mercy in the courtroom, but the most important is because of the bloodshed on Calvary, I found salvation, deliverance. He still delivers, sets free, and heals. Mercy walked in when I fell down on my knees and called upon His name. I stood in.